Welcome to MTSS in Motion. In this series, we examine a multi-tiered system of support framework for meeting the needs of all learners. The topic of this segment is Tier 3 instruction and interventions. Tier 1 is first best instruction, carefully selected to meet the needs of students, and is effective when at least 80% of students are meeting benchmarks for academic, behavioral, and mental wellness goals. Data helps identify students who need supplemental targeted support in addition to the core, which is Tier 2. There are a small number of students who need even more intensive support in an area in order to make progress. In determining Tier 3 supports, ask the following questions. Where is the student performing now? Where do we want him or her to be? How long do we have to get the student there? How much growth is needed per week, month, or year to reach the goal? What will it take to make that happen? While Tier 2 supports center around problem-solving common areas of need, Tier 3 problem-solving is on an individual student level. Instruction, interventions, and supports are specifically targeted to the student's individual needs and provided in an intensive manner. Tier 3 supports are given in addition to the Tier 1 and Tier 2 instruction and supports that are already in place. Tier 3 supports must be evidence-based, targeted to the area of need, and implemented with fidelity. It is important to know the student well in order to select strategies and supports likely to be effective. Tier 3 supports are an intensive resource and should be reserved for students who are not making progress toward goals with Tier 1 and 2 instruction alone. As part of Tier 1, student data is collected and analyzed 3 times a year. Students who are identified as needing supplemental targeted support through Tier 2 are assessed with targeted progress monitoring tools monthly. Students who are receiving Tier 3 support should be assessed even more frequently, typically weekly, with a tool that is aligned with the targeted area of need. Frequent assessment allows schools to determine whether the student is making gains and whether changes are needed. Students receive this support only in the areas they need and for as long as they need it. Frequent assessment enables schools to make appropriate decisions about increasing, changing, or discontinuing support, and to make sure that the school resources are allocated in an effective and equitable way. Thank you for watching MTSS in Motion. For more information, please visit our website at iepta.org to get MTSS in Motion for your district.